Good morning to everybody and thank you to join us today. My name is Andrea Pontoglio and today we will have our webinar called Hospitality Devotion Episode 2. Today with me, Olu Segu, an ex-evangelist of Electron. The agenda of today is why Electron, so who we are, a little summary of our company. Later on, we will show you our portfolio update, that is the fourth update that we have this year. So with our new enchantments regarding touch panels and e-suite. At the end of this webinar, we will have our initiative and conclusion as always. So we will discuss about the product that we saw today and the relative availability. Starting from why Electron? So who is Electron? Story and facts about us. We are a family company founded in 1994. Based now in Legnano, very close to Milano. We are an Italian company where the R&D is totally made here in our factory. This means that we develop our hardware, software, and firmware here in our company. We have branch offices in the world, such as Beijing, Madrid, and Dubai. And one strong point of our company is that we are a certified KNX training center, so we can certify our customer in a KNX standard. And in addition, from 2017, we are inside the KTB. KTB, that is the KNX Technical Board, is a particular association of KNX where the major manufacturer discuss about the protocol. This means that we know in advance the future of the KNX protocol. Together with other manufacturers, we are the pioneer of this protocol. Going ahead, another point that I want to discuss today is regarding the hospitality. We will see our enchantment of our touch panel, the 3.5-inch touch panel, and our access control software called eSuite. So before starts, I want to summarize our news, our actual portfolio of products. Starting from the design switches, we have a complete solution starting from the plastic switch, such as our minipad that receive an update on the plastics, or we can propose our 3025 or 9025, that is a series of glass buttons, thermostat and thermostat plus humidity probe that can be used in any kind of vertical market, starting from residential to hospitality without any problem. This thanks to his aesthetics and also his ETS that can give you a lot of opportunity to fulfill any requirement of your end user. Going ahead, we complete the 1925 series with two new multi-controllers. One with the opportunity to read the ambient temperature and the ambient relative humidity, and another one with an embedded CO2 sensor. This can help for air quality measurement inside your building and manage an air handling unit, for example. We have our complete series of multi-sensor, a new series of presence detector that now is completed also with two new modules called the wide range and corridor. The first one thinking and used to cover huge spaces like open space. This because the coverage of this sensor is 24 meters as diameter, and the corridor, that is a particular presence detector that can be used to manage and control a corridor, as the name suggests. This because we can cover with only one product, one square of 40 meters for 5 meters. We had an update regarding also the actuators. If you remember well in the last webinar, we discussed also regarding the K series, a new actuator series for the control of lighting and shutters. So we complete our solution of actuator with this new series. And we have also the opportunity to manage other kind of actuator for HVAC, for example. Since we have in our portfolio the F series, a multi-purpose actuator that gives you the opportunity to control lighting system, shutter system, but also any kind of HVAC system managed by relay. Regarding other actuators, we have gateways to control and manage the DALI system, and also a fan coil actuator to manage fan coil with a 0 to 10 volt signal. In addition, as you can see from this slide, we have the opportunity to provide you one micro SD card for the F series. This can be useful to faster replace of the product, first of all, since you just need to remove the old product from the installation, replace with a new one, and just swap the SD card. With this operation, we will restore the entire ETS application, bringing also the physical address to the new device. In this way, you need only one spare device for type, for model, and not for room, for example, if we are talking about an hotel. On GED, we have our Otomo, that is a system based on Bluetooth Low Energy, where devices creates a mesh network between them, and in this way, we can send messages over Bluetooth. So also, if we don't reach directly the last device in our building with our phone, the message to turn on a light or remove a shutter is forwarded between devices thanks to our mesh network based on Bluetooth Low Energy. We have in our portfolio our IP devices with KNX Secure already embedded in our interface, so we have the opportunity to control and manage without any problem a KNX Secure system thanks to our IP and router IP interface. We have, and we had also a new update on our access control system. As you can see in this slide, we don't have anymore our synchronicity devices, but we have our 9025 for the access control system. If you lost our last webinar, I suggest you to find out the record of the webinar on our YouTube channel that will be ready very soon. Today, we will discuss about eSuite, so the update that we will bring with eSuite with our new access control. And we will talk also about our 3.5-inch touch panel. So as you remember, actually, in our portfolio, we have already a 3.5-inch touch panel, but nowadays we are refreshing it, and later we will see how. Starting from the actual version of the touch panel, as you already know, is an in-wall mounting touch panel that has a direct KNX connection, so you don't need any kind of IP interface or IP router interface to connect this touch panel to the KNX system. And is powered by an auxiliary power supply that can be from 9 to 32 volt DC. This means that we can use an external power supply or use the auxiliary power output of our KNX power supply if we have enough power in the power supply. As installation, we can install this touch panel in a 2 or 3 module backbox without any problem. This is our new evolution of the touch panel. As you can see, we change the plastic, so the external frame is renewed, and as you can see, follow the family feeling of the 9025. In addition, as you can note already from the first screenshot that we have on the top left side of this slide, we enchant this touch panel also with a series of icons that remember the 9025 series. And then later we will see other examples. In addition, this panel, as you can see from the second photo on this slide, can be used as HMI, so human machine interface, that can be used not only to send command to the KNX bus, such as overwrite a set point or send a new command for the lighting system, but can be used also as a feedback panel. So as you can see from the second sample, we use it to check the room quality. For example, thanks to our 9025 or multi-sensor, we can have the value on the KNX bus of the actual VOC or CO2, and we can show it without any problem on our touch panel. Let's see the new feature that we have in our touch panel. Starting from the opportunity to have not only a list as a main menu of the pages, but now we can have a button view for the main menu. In addition, I want to remember you that inside the touch panel, we have the opportunity to enable the wiki calendar. This is because inside of the touch panel, there is present RTC, so a real-time clock. So we can set date and time on the touch panel and manage, for example, lighting system, shutter system, HVAC, and so on. So everything that is KNX can be set under a scheduler. We have also the opportunity to use it as single room control or multiple room control. In a residential project, we can use it to control the main room or the dining room, for example. Or if we place this touch panel inside an office, with only one touch panel, we manage the HVAC of our offices. In addition, you can find an embedded buzzer with the opportunity to perform an alarm, so we can manage also up to 8 different alarms. This means that if we have an alarm on our technical room, for example, we can turn on the buzzer and show an alarm on the screen. We update the plastic, as we said, but the screen remains the same. So is the 3.5-inch resistive screen. Going ahead, you can find inside the hardware an embedded temperature probe. This means that you can read the ambient temperature directly from the touch panel and use it to enable a regulator inside the device. This means that this touch panel could be also the thermostat of your room. And as, let's say, maximum limit of object that we can show and control in our touch panel is 48, since we can enable up to 6 pages where we can place up to 8 different commands inside each page. We renovated the frame design following the 1925 series. We enchanted our ETS application. Following the feedback of the market, we add parameters to help you to customize as you wish our product. And I want to remember you that for the moment, there is no external software to customize the product. This means that you don't need to download any other software, but all the configuration and customization is made directly from the ETS if you use our standard icon that we will preload in our touch panel. Otherwise, I want to remember you that it's always possible to load thanks to the eTouch panel software. So you can customize not only the graphics, but also the icon inside the touch panel as you wish. We add a new preloaded set of icons. So you can find not only the old icons that you already know regarding our touch panel Electa, but in addition, we add new icons to follow the 1925 family feeling. In this way, if you have a complete system with our product, with our 1925 button and thermostat, you can replicate the same icon inside the touch panel. Could be very useful for end users. Another modification that we made is that micro USB and micro SD card is accessible from the front panel, so you don't need anymore to unmount from the wall the device. In the past, with the old model squared or the Electra version of the touch panel, you have to unmount the device to reach the mini USB port. So first of all, we upgraded the USB from mini USB to micro USB. And in addition, now micro SD card and micro USB are accessible directly from the front of the device. This means that if you need to customize icon or change the screensaver, for example, with a photo of the family if we are in a residential project, or a photo of the logo of the company if you are in an office project, can be done directly without unmounting the device from the wall. So as we said, we add new icons and give you also the opportunity to customize with new parameters the screen of our panel. So starting from offices, we can give you the opportunity to manage a lighting system, shutter, HVAC, air quality. So everything that is in KNX, that can be a KNX telegram, can be shown and managed inside our touch panel. For example, we can manage without any problem any kind of 2-byte float, 4-byte float, telegram, 1-byte signal or unsignaled. So don't worry, also if you are integrating something that is not KNX and the gateway give you a particular telegram, we can integrate it without any problem in our screen. We can use the screen also in apartment, for example. Here in the screenshot, we made an example of how we can manage without any problem any kind of lighting system. Starting from the fourth row, where you can find a spotlight, so a simple on-off, or we can control a strip LED that is dimmable with a simple slider, or also we can manage without any problem RGB lights. So with the plus and minus button, we can dim up and dim down the RGB light. And if we press on the percentage, a palette of colors is shown whether to manage and change the color. And in the last row of this example, there is a time scheduler. So as you can see, there is the opportunity to turn on and off all the lights thanks to the plus and minus button, or pressing the icon with the sun with all, we enter inside a scheduler and we can schedule when we want to turn on or off the lighting system. Of course, in this case, I create a scheduler that controller and take care about the one bit control, so a simple on off. But if we want to change the percentage of the neighbor lamp taking care about the time, we can do that without any problem. So we just need to enable a time scheduler over the one byte telegram to manage the percentage. We can use this touch panel also in hospital clinics or rest homes. And as I said at the beginning, we have inside an internal buzzer. So we can show alarms, as in this case, we manage and control 8 beds. So we have 3 rooms where we have a total of 8 beds, and we manage the alarm. So in this way, if there is a problem, an alarm is showed, for example, in the nursery room. In this way, the nurse can go in the room, in this case 3D, to check what happened inside the room. So now, thanks to our new icons and new customization that you can perform in our touch panel, you can propose without any problem this touch panel in any kind of vertical market. Of course, we bring inside our touch panel also our new icons of the access control system. So if you want, you can use this touch panel, for example, in a suite. So in standard room and premium room, you can propose our 9025 switch plus the 9025 thermostat. And in the suite of the hotel, you can propose the touch panel as control panel for the suite. So in this way, you can have more command in only one place. You can enable up to 6 pages, and in each page you can insert about up to 8 command. And in this case, we have a dedicated page for the guest. In this way, he has a scenario called master off to turn off all the light, and 3 buttons to call the service, request the D&D, or request the makeup room. So this because, as we said also in the previous slide, we worked a lot of the new icon that we are preloading in our touch panel. So a new manual also that explain how to use this new icon will be delivered soon with the product. For the moment, I finished my part, so I let Paolo to continue this webinar. Thank you everybody for the moment.
Good morning. My name is Paolo, and today will be my pleasure to introduce you to our guest room management system. Okay, we are used to think about hospitality. We are used to think about others, but we can say that we are well recognized as a technology provider, not only for others, but for the main verticals that are shown here, like resorts, student houses, rented apartments, and senior living houses. And we have already shared in a previous webinar some numbers about our success. We start more than 20 years ago, and we are very proud to say that we install in more than 700 hotels our guest room management system that is called the eSuite. I can also share some references. So when we say main verticals, we also talk about geography. We have installed our system in Europe, but also in Middle East area and in Far East, as you can see, Singapore. It's not reported here, but we have also some installation in South America. Okay, let's talk about what is eSuite today. eSuite is our guest room management system. It was designed many years ago, and the main goal at that time was to provide a solution to manage the access control devices, means car readers and holders. What does it mean to manage access control readers and holders? Basically means to create a car for a guest, so make the check-in and check-out at the reception. Next to this basic function about treating a car for guests, we also add through the time a visualization part or supervision part of the system. Means that we can control alarm function, and we can also manage the staff. What means manage the staff? Means create cards not only for guests, but also create card for the staff, so services card. Is also capable to interact with other system like the property management system, but we have focused slides that we can talk later. So the main task of eSuite was to manage as fast as possible the check-in and check-out for the guest. And this is a very important task because You know, it's always boring to wait a lot in front of the front desk when you want just to reach your room. So what we have done is to try to simplify as best we can this procedure. What we have to expect with the eSuite model year 21? One of the major improvements regards the guide, so the graphical user interface. You know, today people are used to interact not only with desktop or laptops, computers, but also with tablets and mobile phone. So we have tried to make it easier for the receptionist to approach the user of eSuite through a new graphical user interface. Connect to access control devices means that today eSuite is capable to drive the new 9025 range access control devices. We have also worked a lot to grab all the capabilities provided by the new hardware. We have already introduced the new hardware in a previous webinar, and there's really a big improvement in terms of features and functions. So we have tried to report as best as we can all these features also into the eSuite software. We have listened to the feedback of our customer and integrators, and probably one of the least features of eSuite was the alarm management. So we have improved the way we can manage the alarm that comes from the devices and the alarm that are generated automatically by the software. Big work and with a big effort has been done to rewrite many of the modules of eSuite. You know, eSuite is composed by different modules. And probably this is a work behind the scene because it's not really visible in terms of functionality. But a big effort has been spent to, especially all the IP network services. The eSuite is based on a client-server architecture, so most of the traffic is made on the network. So improve the network services means also improve the reliable of the system and also improve the speed of reaction of the system. We have already connected eSuite to many other third-party systems or software, but on our roadmap, this is increasing a lot. And we're working a lot to improve also this integration and connectivity. And now let's go deeper through the bullets to better understand what we would like to introduce. A new graphical user interface is the front desk, the receptionist that interacts every day with the software, and he has to react as fast as he can in front of a guest to reduce the time of waiting for the guest, the receptionist. So new design layout means that we have approached the office layout with dark theme mode to make it more fresh, probably, but also more usable. We propose the dark mode as a default themes for eSuite, for the new eSuite model year 21. But as usual, if you don't like this theme, you can always switch to your operating system theme. Designing the new interface, we also put a note on the touchscreen monitors. What does it mean? That today, many laptops or desktops comes from the market equipped with a touch monitor screen. Think about all-in-one desktop. So the idea is to give the possibility to the receptionist to not interact for the basic operation with the keyboard, but directly swipe the screens and using the gesture interact with the eSuite software. And as reported before by Andrea, the work that has been done for the icons for the new touch screen, let me say that will be inherited also in eSuite, means that as before, we are used to provide a set of icons that can be used for the visualization part of the system, not for the access control, for the supervision part. To make a convergence of the family feelings about our devices, we think that it's a good idea also to share these icons for eSuite. In this way, we can say that you will see the same icons on the hardware, maybe on the capacitive switches, on a touchscreen installed in the same room, and at the end, also in the visualization part of the guest room management system. This is to make it more easy for the user to understand what has to be done. We have talked about alarms. Is it an important task for the receptionist to react very fast and immediately to an alarm that fire into the system. And according to the new specification of the new readers and holder of the 9025 range, now we can manage up to 7 different classes of alarms. Usually when you swipe a card in front of a reader, you can be granted or not to access the room or to pass through the door. With the previous version of the hardware, unfortunately, we cannot understand why we can't access to a door. So we received just a feedback, you are not allowed. Today, we can have seven different status if you cannot grant an alarm. Maybe the day of the week is not correct according to the profile of your card. Maybe the time slot of the day, maybe the period is completely ended and expired. Next to these alarms that comes from the hardware installed into the bus network, we have also reviewed the alarms profile in the software. So now we can manage up to 10 alarm profiles. Means that for every object that you define as an alarm, you can decide if a pop-up has to be shown to advise the receptionist, if a sound has to be used as an alert again for the receptionist, or if an email has to be sent to the staff member, so for the user of eSuite allowed to receive email from the systems. The main task of eSuite is to welcome a guest. And we can say that we have two phases of the system. The first one is used in the small, medium-sized hotels, where eSuite has to be considered as a standalone self-managed guest and services card. So it's the only software system or system available in the hotel to manage the card, so to create card for the guest and services. But in case we have big installations, so big hotels to manage, eSuite can act as a key system, so it's a part of complete solution. And we are the client for the main software system of the hotel just to prepare the key for the guest. When we talk about the guest room management system, we have to think about a solution, not only devices or software. And a part of the solution is the card encoder, is an important equipment for the receptionist because it's the tool that is used to physically encode some information on the card to make it possible for the guest to enter into his room and to access to common areas that maybe are defined into the solution. What has been done about the card encoder? So a new card encoder is provided and it belongs to the 9025 range. So we have an RGB bar. It seems to be a simple feature, but it's very powerful because the receptionist can immediately understand if the card has been encoded correctly or not. Because we use the RGB bar showing green, red light, blinking green light during the encoding of the card. So the receptionist can immediately understand what is happening. Another important part of the system is the database engine. Is the engine that collects all the information and manages all the information of the guest and also of the visualization part. We have improved the engine. That means we now use the latest version of the engine. And this means that we can have best performance in terms of speed of reaction of the system when we make the queries and more reliable because it has been developed according to the latest operating system. Another part of the solution is the license dongle. Our license model is based on a USB dongle. In the past, we have faced some issue for the driver of the dongle to be installed. Today, we use a driverless dongle. It's easy to use because you don't have to install driver at the end. Our proposal for the guest room management system is based mainly on two hardwares. We are used to sell eSuite pre-installed on a hardware computer. That is a part of the solution. You have to consider this desktop or server as a device next to the card readers and holders and the software and so on. So it's a part of the solution. And when we have to provide our guest room management system for small hotels, we like to propose the Nook. It's a small computer, easy to maintain because you can install under the reception desk. So no special rooms are required, no racks where to install the computer. We say it's a small computer with normal performance. I don't want to say small or big, let me say normal performance. And it works very fine. It's easy to maintain. But in case we are looking at big installation with big hotels, we would like to push the idea to use a rack-based server because for sure in the hotel, you have a room dedicated for the IT equipment. The IT manager is used to work with these kind of computers It's bigger also inside, means that we can install at least two hard drive to make a RAID configuration. It's bigger, so we have two dual IP port, so we can uncouple the business network from the bus network. It's more expandable, it's more powerful, and it's more reliable, let me say. Let's think about the right choice when you quote an hotel. First of all, we have our guest that has to experience the best in the hotel. Next to him, we have all the equipments that fill the room. So we have switches, we have actuators, touch panels in the room to make it more comfortable for the guest. And these devices are based on the KNX technology. Up, we have the eSuite software that is used to manage the access control, but also to make the visualization part of the system. Remember that you can always control the temperature in a room or the status of an alarm. And here we show the hardware where is based eSuite, NUC or REC. And in case of a REC, we have the business network uncoupled from the bus network. A couple of slides of the new graphical user interface of eSuite is just to give you a preview, because I hope that you will can attend to next webinars more technical and more dedicated to eSuite. This is our team, the default one that will be present. And just let me put a note about the new menu, that it's in a style like what you can see in a tablet or in a mobile phone, so in an HTML application, where you can have a complete menu with all the descriptions, or as in the next slide, with just the icons, to have more space in your desktop to arrange your windows and see the information that are required from the front desk or from the back office. Let's talk about the PMS and spend a few words about the property management system. What is a PMS system for the hotel? The PMS is the main software that collects all the information from the, I like to say, satellite. So from all the other software that are required in an hotel, like the pay TV or the phone systems, the minibars, and everything. So the software collects all the information to provide at the end bill for the guest. So we become the key system for the PMS. So we are the one that receive the request to make a key for a guest. So it has no sense to duplicate the information in the PMS and in our solution, in our software, to make a key for a guest. All the information comes through a software interface, and we have just to encode a key for the guest. So connecting the PMS to eSuite means reduce the operator workload, because as I said before, the receptionist has not to type twice details of the guest. Reduce the time required for a check-in or a check-out, because probably in the PMS, all the details are already stored and he has just to press a couple of key to make a check-in and check-out. And avoid duplication of data information available on the system. Which kind of function are interfaced between the two systems? Check-in, check-out, the room move, guest details, creation key, delete key. So these are the standard functions that are transferred. But we are open in case you have to interface a system that has not been already interfaced to eSuite to listen to your request to integrate new function or to completely create a new software interface for a new PMS that is not in our list of compatibility. We say that a big improvement has been made about connectivity with the eSuite model year 21. So today, IT manager has to fight every day with hack attacking to their systems. And the cybersecurity teams appears every day into the news of a solution. So we strongly suggest to use the REC system, because we physically uncouple the two networks, the business network and the operational network, because we have onboard two network cards. Let me say that in any case, a big work has been done to rewrite all the network services to make it more reliable and robust. Many years ago, eSuite start as a door access system, so just to manage the access control. Then we put new features in the software to make a visualization, to make it possible for the user, the back office or from the front desk, to interact with the rooms, equipments like the thermostat just to change a set point. But today we think about a framework to create a core to extend the services and the function of the software and of the solution. What we like to do is to not only control locally in real time, monitoring and controlling in real time the devices, but also collect all this information to make it possible later to do data analysis and dashboarding. This is in our roadmap about eSuite. So to make it possible for someone that has already installed eSuite in his facility, also to collect information that can be later used. Remember that we have already introduced in the previous webinar our dashboarding system. This will be one of the actors that will populate our dashboard. And it's summarized here in this slide. So the low level or the raw level is the equipment installed on the facility as KNX devices. eSuite become the collector that listen to the telegrams running on the bus, can forward this information to our dashboarding system. And on the dashboarding system, everything can be remanaged and analyzed. We have also worked a lot to interface eSuite with our Horizon web server. Horizon is capable to make the visualization and is capable also to share this visualization on a mobile or tablet, is capable to talk on KNX with the other devices, and is connected to an IP network. So we have a couple of applications dedicated to the access control. This is called a virtual badge. And a virtual badge is also used to give the possibility to the guests of an hotel to interact directly with all the equipments of his room. To make it easier to use these new features available through Horizon, we thought to make eSuite the coordinator of the Horizon installed in the hotel. So this is a new nice feature, I think, for eSuite that acts as a coordinator for many Horizon installed in a hotel. A recap of the architecture of our solution. When we think about hospitality, we have to talk about solutions, and the solution is composed. We start from the hardware installed on the building. We pass through the property management system, so software that comes from third-party system, the guest room management system, our eSuite, and everything works together to make it possible for the guest to have the best experience and for the receptionist to react at the request of his guest, like very fast, as make up room, do not disturb, or generic request that comes from the guest. Which kind of services can offer eElectron next to the software and to the hardware? One of the most important, I think, is the mock-up room implementation assistance. It means that we can help the integrators to set up a mock-up room to show exactly to the hotel owner, if we're thinking about implementing an hotel, to make it possible for the hotel owner to directly experience the reaction of the hardware, the software, and all the functions that can be available in a room. So we can help our distributors and integrators to define which kind of devices are required, and also we can provide an ETS project to make it easier and faster for them to set up a mock-up room. We can customize the capacitive switches, for example, with dedicated icons and pictograms. We can help the integrators to understand how to connect to the PMS system or to the other system that are present in the hotels. At the end, if you win the project, we can also pre-program in factory. We can pre-program your devices that you have ordered according to your ETS project. This speeds up a lot the setup of the complete building because you receive on-site devices already programmed. As usual, we support our customer with dedicated trainings in case of request. Let's see the part numbers, the ordering part numbers for what we have presented today. So we have the new touch panel in white and black colors. We have the software, the guest room management systems, and we have to spend a few words about the license model of eSuite Model Year 21. So when you decide to buy a license of eSuite, you have to buy the first part number, the embedded PC with eSuite software, full package, and then you have to buy as many licenses per single room as required. This is complete the solution. Then you can decide to upgrade to Red PC, and is strongly suggested for big installation, let me say for big hotels. eSuite clients, the best license comes with two clients already enabled in your solution, means that you can have different stations working on the same project, different, more than one front desk, maybe one front desk and one back office. So this is the additional client license. Interface to management systems is the interface to PMS system, to the property management system. We have already a list of PMS already interfaced with our system. In case you need an interface that has not been developed, we can develop it for sure with a part number that is called the eSuite Interface to Management System Custom Development. eSuite Interface to Horizon and Virtual Badge is the possibility and the capability of eSuite to act as a coordinator for the Horizons, and you need a license to do this. And the P-Tunneling module, eSuite is capable to connect to more than one IP interface in case you want to uncouple the KNX trunk using IP interfaces. By default, you are enabled just to connect to one IP interface or to the USB interface. If you need more, you have to buy this license. And what happens if you have already installed eSuite? As previously, the backward compatibility is always guaranteed. If you would like to upgrade to the latest version of eSuite, is it possible? No worries. As usual, we also give you an overview of the technical and sales documentation and demo kits, so we can provide leaflet, catalogs in different languages. But I think that the most important part are the demo packages where that can be used to show to your customer and to see how it looks a real device with the demo packages. Or the demo case that is more intended, I think, for the training of yourself, of your integrators, because it's a demo case full of devices. Most of them belongs to the 1925 ranges, but you have a switch pad, you have a thermostat, you have present detectors. And the lab test kit that is not bundled in a predefined demo case, but you receive a set of components that can be used to start to understand how KNX works and how our devices based on KNX technology can be used. If you want to be updated on our news, you have to subscribe to our newsletter. Meet the company, and now I can call back also Andrea.
I want to say thank you for your time. Thank you also Paolo and all the other colleagues that are with us.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Have a nice day. Bye-bye.